Hello, I'm Roger McLaughlin, Chief Executive of the Westerly Group. It's a great pleasure to welcome you to our Christmas Remembrance Service. Now, of course, with COVID, things are much harder to organise this year than in the past. And there was a danger we couldn't have this service at all. But our colleagues, together with our audiovisual partners, Obitus, have come to the rescue. And hence, we're doing this webcast live to you this evening, and also recorded for those of you who can't attend at this time. Of course, I mentioned there COVID, and it's affected all of us. And much has been written and said about how devastating it's been. And sadly, we have lost many lives. But you know, there has been an awful lot of good come out of this pandemic too. There are heroes in every community, in every walk of life. People who've really gone the extra mile. And of course, yes, there's all the key workers. NHS have been magnificent, as have been lorry drivers getting food to the supermarkets, teachers who carried on teaching and looking after the young people. And in every community, there's someone who has gone the extra mile, a real hero. Whether they just brought about a smile, whether they've checked on their neighbours, whether they've got shopping for them. Or perhaps it's been you, making a call to someone who you haven't spoken to for a while. Make more of those calls, especially at Christmas. There's never been a better time to do it. So phone a friend. And of course, if I may, I'd like to thank all our Westerly colleagues who have been magnificent during this pandemic. They have worked tirelessly, all hours, with great dedication, to provide the love, the exceptional care for absolutely everyone who's suffered a bereavement. So tonight, please do enjoy this service. Enjoy the singing, enjoy taking part as much as you can, and have a very Merry Christmas. Thank you.
But I think we're all very aware that many of you who watch this service, not only has COVID-19 affected this year, but many of you will have lost loved ones. And our hope and our prayer is that this service will bring some comfort and some joy of Christmas to you. We're joined wonderfully by choirs who, through the wonders of technology, are with us. And we're going to listen now to our first hymn. It's the choir of King's College, Cambridge, singing Silent Night.
Thank you. The Meeting by Henry Wordsworth Longfellow. After so long an absence, at last we meet again. Does the meeting give us pleasure, or does it give us pain? The tree of life has been shaken, but few of us linger now, like the prophet's two or three berries in the top of the uppermost bough. We cordially greet each other in the old familiar tone, and we think, though we do not say it, how old and grey he is grown. We speak of a Merry Christmas and many a Happy New Year, but each in his heart is thinking of those that are not here. We speak of friends and their fortunes, and of what they did and said, till the dead alone seem living, and the living alone seem dead. And at last, we hardly distinguish between the ghosts and the guests, and a mist and shadow of sadness stills over our merriest jests.
Thank you. Our next carol takes me back to school nativity plays when I was probably a donkey. It's always been a little bit like that. Maybe you were a Mary or a Joseph. I've never been one of the wise men. But we're going to listen now to Once in Royal David City.
Once in
Royal David City,
stood I, Lord, in heaven.
this year has certainly been different. It's none of us could have guessed the sort of year we would have all had. And of course that means that Christmas is different this year as well. Some person wittier than me said, if we think of the Christmas story, well, the shepherds up there in the hills, they've been furloughed. The three wise men are not allowed to travel this year. And the inn, well, it's shut, except for takeaways. But it's different for everyone, but it's particularly different for those of you that have lost loved ones during this year, who will be thinking back to happier times, no doubt. A few months ago, there was some debate about whether Christmas would take place, and I read in a newspaper quite an angry response from a clergyman. What he was saying was, well look, the real Christmas can still exist, because the real Christmas is the story of Christ coming as a baby into this world, and of course I believe that to be true, but I'm not sure he got it totally right. One thing that I think was a masterstroke was the fact that when in ancient days the church chose this time to be the time that Christmas was celebrated, that the birth of Christ was celebrated, they in fact adopted a festival that already existed. So our pagan forefathers worked out that at this time of year, the nights had got so long and the days had become so short, but suddenly that was going to change and there was going to be light that was going to come and there was going to be hope again of lighter days. And I actually think those two elements of Christmas go together. Yes, Christians believe that Christ coming into the world as a baby brought light and brought hope, but they celebrated it at a time when, as I say, our poor pagan forefathers already saw that this was a very special time of year. So I see two Christmases. I see, yes, the Christian celebration, but Christmas, or Yuletide as it used to be called, has always been a time when people got together, when they wanted to celebrate together, and they wanted to eat together and think of happier days ahead. And that makes me think where many of us are for this year, that this year has been an unprecedented, a tough year for everyone. And for those that have lost loved ones, well, that sadness is still there. There's a poem that I use sometimes in funerals, and it has words on it like this. You mustn't grieve forever. Your loved one wouldn't want you to. They hope that you would carry on in the ways you always do. So talk about the good times and the ways you showed you cared. And I really hope that this Christmas that you will find joy and you will in some ways be able to carry on in the ways that you always do. I'm going to ask our organist now, Carl the Provo, who works here at Test Valley, to play for us.
Thank you.
part of the team here is going to read our second poem now.
When every guest has taken leave and gifts are all unwrapped and gone, I take a little time to ponder on those good memories that linger on. The magic of the season with scents of holly, wax and pine, the dancing lights upon the tree that lighten darkness as they shine. I call back moments from the past of journeys made, so far to go. I remember the words that still inspire, spoken both today and long ago. When loved ones gather round, we remember those whose voice is still, and in the Christmas joys of sorrow, their love lives on and always will.
Thank you so much. As you've probably realised, no expense has been spared this evening in what we're bringing to you. And just to prove that, we've got our next carol now, O Come All Ye Faithful, sung by none other than Susan Boyle.
I am your star. Remember me with heartfelt smiles, the sort that shines for miles and miles. For while you are sad and feeling low, nothing can change, I had to go. But if you face the world and grin, keeping memories safe and warm within, then somewhere deep inside your heart, you will almost feel we are not apart. We see stars shining in the sky, forgetting they have long since died. So, see that light and feel it too. I am your star, I shine for you.
Test Valley Crematorium really does have something of a special atmosphere. Whenever I come here, I find everyone very professional, very committed to their work, very compassionate, but also very friendly. And I think a lot of that goes down to Rob Metcalf, who's the manager here, and he's now coming to say a few words.
Thank you very much, Dave, for those very kind words indeed. Good evening, everyone. My name is Robert Metcalf, and I want to start by thanking you all for watching this Christmas Remembrance Service. I stand here today with sadness and pride. It is a privilege to speak on behalf of Test Valley Crematorium as we remember, grieve, and celebrate everyone who is greatly missed and cherished. We are hurting, and we want to send our love to the families who join us today. Throughout the pandemic, my colleagues have continued to be and are simply amazing. They're constantly putting the family's needs before their own. My team stepped forward to serve whenever required. For that, I thank you from the bottom of my heart, even as I acknowledge that this is not over yet. Each dear soul that was lost was unique, loved, and missed terribly. These people touched people's lives. They changed people's lives. We are hurting, but we are determined to look forward, keep hope in our hearts, and work hard to care for our families. A hand of love and support is extended, always, to families, and we wish them the courage and strength in the days, months, and years ahead. Thank you very much.
There's a passage in the Old Testament of the Bible that speaks about the coming of the Messiah, the coming of Jesus. And it says, "The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light." As this has been such a difficult year for all of us, but particularly for those that have lost a loved one, I'm just going to pray a short prayer now that somehow we might know light. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, you promised that those who have known darkness will know light. My prayer for all those that are watching this service, that they might know a sense of that light coming into their lives. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So it just leaves me now to wish you all a good Christmas and, we trust, a happier 2021.